The latest alcohol crackdown at King's Cross is already being picked apart, with critics insisting it's little more than window dressing and won't go anywhere near far enough to end the violence. Josh Murphy is there for us tonight. Josh, even the government concedes this isn't a perfect solution.
Yeah, Bill, that concession was made by the state government today, but it did come with a promise that there is more announcements to come. Now, the perception from some of the venues up here is that these new drinking restrictions simply tinker around the edges. Some fear it will also cost them hundreds of thousands of dollars, but fail to change the area's drinking culture.
This is the Cross, where the screams of fun too often turn to the scream of sirens. Prompted by the death of Thomas Kelly, tough new venue restrictions have been unveiled.
Well, it's not a silver bullet, and I can't give any guarantees.
And already there is resistance from some pubs that restrictions on how many drinks you can buy won't work, and cutting service an hour before closing will cause more problems.
The last thing we would want to see for the police, for the venues, or for the amenity is 20,000 people entered onto the street in one hit.
Which some argue would create more of this and more mopping up. There are also claims of inequality on forcing venues to install more CCTV on the street.
The venues up there have got 750 cameras, the council's got 3.
The government is still pushing ahead with a trial of sobering up centres, where drunks will be taken to cool off, one possibly headed for King's Cross, but there's not yet a time frame.
The only thing I can offer you is that to say that sobering up centres remain a part of our policy to implement, and it is intended to do so.
The policy was announced well before the election, more than 18 months ago, and has its critics.
The government should concede that this was a flawed idea and instead put the money that would be spent on it into increasing police numbers in and around King's Cross.
Now, in terms of another major missing factor in reforming the Cross is improving transport, more taxis and trains to get people in and out. The government says at this stage that plan is incomplete, but it is underway. Bill and Sam.
Thank you. Josh Murphy at King's Cross.